Hello everyone, I'm back. And in this video I'm going to put the third layer on my geode. And I don't know if you can see it, but I already placed some pointy crystals on the fire glass. And now I'm placing some clear over them to make sure that they stay at the place that I want. So in this layer I'm going to also add the white and the gold. And yeah, let's see how this goes. First, on the outer barrier, against it, some clear. It dried very nice. I'm very happy with it so far. And also the glitter looks very nice in it. Bleeded nicely together. Make sure that I have all around the barrier the clear. And now again, I'm putting a very thin line of blue on top of the clear, the same blue as I used in the first and the second layer. It's a transparent blue of Eli Gem, and I want it a little bit darker on the outside, so a very thin line. Again, some clear. I'm gonna use in this layer a lot of clear because I want to lay the colors over each other to create some depth. And now on top of the clear I'm going to put some gold in some areas. So first we have the clear, then we have the transparent blue, and on top of that I'm going to place the gold in some places, and I hope that they are bleeding very nice together, that I can create some special effects. And this is the gold of Resitint Plus. It's the rich gold, very nice color. And I hope that it looks like it's floating on top. So not all the way around the gold, but in some places. So now a little bit of heat, because the rich gold reacts on the heat, gives us very special effects. And you can already see that the blue, the transparent blue and the gold are bleeding together. I like that. Now again, a Bombay ink with a glitter mix in it. It's such a nice color, so I'm also put it in this layer. Very thin line. Again, some clear against the glitter. And And over the purple, also some clear. Yeah, and the gold looks already very good. Last bit of clear. Yes, and I also need to use some white, and I'm putting it around the fire glass, not too much, thin line, heating it up, and now I'm trying to blow the white color over the clear. But I need to watch out that I don't burn my resin. Again, some Bombay ink with the glitter. And now a very dark purple, that's the Royal Purple of Artisou, and I mixed a lot of vintage violet glitter in it, so it sparkles a lot, but you get a nice contrast this way. So all the way around also this color. Heating it up again to blend those colors. Yeah, and I'm getting some nice effects with the gold. So some clear to fill up some gaps. So the last bit of clear, and now again some heat, because I want to push that purple, dark purple color over the clear. A little bit difficult with the glitter in it, because you also need to watch out that you don't burn the glitter. Again, some gold all around the white. And now again some heat to see what effects the gold gives us. A little bit of purple because I had an open space there. More gold. Yes, almost done with this layer, and now is the question, should I put acrylic lines on it or not? So everyone that watches this video can decide if I put the acrylic lines on it or not. So I will put this in the description box and you can place a comment with a yes or no, and then I will see it and I will count the votes. And which gets the most votes, I will do. So you can decide if I'm going to put the acrylic lines on it or not. So the last bit of heat. At the end of this video, again, after an hour, I filmed it again, and it changed a lot, so if you want to see it, then you need to wait, and you can also see it up close, so, yeah, then you need to wait until the end of this video. So this is after 1 hour. It's a little bit hard filming in the sun, but I do my best. So it changed. The gold has nice effects and also the glitter. So you can see, I like it very much. The gold and the transparent blue have bleeded nicely together. And also the gold in the purple. It has great depth, but you can't see it on the video. But it has a lot of depth in it. See in the gold, very nice effects. All the glitter. In the white, also some nice effects. I'm happy with this piece. There you see the crystals I placed, the pointy crystals. So don't forget to vote. I will place it in the description box. Yes for the acrylic lines or no. And I'm very curious what you all gonna vote for. So I want to thank you all for watching. And if you didn't subscribe yet, please do so. And if you have comments or tips, please place it under the video. And I will see you next time. Bye.